So now we're going to see the chapter called as the living world. Okay, it's a very small chapter. I mean the living world and biological classification both together. Okay, so the living world and biological classification. Okay, if you see that in this chapter we're going to see the basics. Okay, like how is the entire the kingdom classified, on what basis, what are the terms used, what is the need for classification. Okay, see, the living world is vast. We've got millions and millions of species around, plants, animals, microbes, okay, algae, fungi. So all there are like many categories. So how did we manage to, you know, define that species in that particular group, and how are we defining the characteristics, and what is the basics of that is what we're going to see now. Okay, first of all, how do you differentiate the living organisms from the non-living? See, the living organisms will mainly possess few important characteristics. 3, 4, 5. Okay. The first and foremost being growth. Okay. Any living organisms will grow. Definitely they will grow. Okay. So growth is seen only in the living organisms. Okay. Next is that reproduction. You can observe reproduction only in the living organisms. Then your metabolism. Okay, that is your anabolism and catabolism. The body building up, breaking down, all these. Next is that your cellular organization. Okay, what is it? Like organ level, organ system, tissue level, all these things. And the last one is consciousness. Okay, so these are the main five parameters which will differentiate the living and the non-living organisms. I can also say locomotion, but it is not, yes, locomotion can also be included. Okay, locomotion or movement. Okay, now fine. So the living organisms, so these are all the parameters which will differentiate the living organisms from the non-living organisms. So if you see the growth, okay, the organisms, any organism should grow. Only if it is growing, it will exist. Okay, so growth in the sense, see, for us growth is the cell number will increase. But in lower organisms, growth itself is a reproduction. Okay, so whatever it is, they will tend to maintain their cells. They will tend to pass on the genetic information. So that process is continuously being done. Then reproduction. So reproduction, if you see, there are many types of reproduction, like asexual, sexual reproduction. Sexual reproduction involves the fusion of gametes. Okay, the male and female gametes will fuse. Okay, whereas asexual, you have many methods. For example, budding in hydra, okay, then binary fission and paramecium, cell division. So likewise, lot of methodologies are there in the reproduction, asexual reproduction, okay, vegetative propagation, many things are there. So the organism should find some or the other way to reproduce. If not, it cannot win the race. Okay, say for example, there exists an organism A. It cannot reproduce, but it is there. But what happens after a point of time, it will die, and that's it. That is the end of that particular organism. So it is not being carried out. You don't even know if that organism existed because it dies as such. So any organism, it should reproduce to maintain its its uniqueness. Then metabolism. Metabolism can be of two types: anabolism and catabolism. So anabolism is building up and catabolism is breaking down. Okay, so building up in the sense, the building blocks of the protein, the amino acids are all gathered together to make a protein, the protein synthesis, glucose metabolism, glucose, proteins, carbohydrates, all these are produced in the body. Okay, so whenever there is a need, okay, so vitamins, okay, so what is this anabolism? Is that whatever you need inside the body that is produced by accumulation of the tiny entities, okay, that is building up mechanism or anabolism. Catabolism is breaking down. I'm breaking down the carbohydrate into glucose. okay, I'm breaking down the proteins into amino acids. So that is called as catabolism. Then your cellular organization. So you know well, we've seen in animal kingdom, we have a cellular type, or tissue type, organ, organ system, etc. So the basic, very normal one is your cellular level, then your tissue level. Okay. So accordingly, the organisms, they are placed down the lane in the evolutionary chart. Okay. Cellular is a very basic level. Organ system is the highest level. Okay. Consciousness. Yes. Consciousness is kind of, this is a unique property found only in the living organisms. The exact definition or how it works, you cannot explain it. Technically, it is, little complicated. But consciousness is seen only in the living organisms. Locomotion or movement. Okay. So, the organism will move some or the other way. See, it can be, what is the difference between locomotion and movement? Locomotion, there will be change in the place. Movement is, in one place itself, there will be the movement, to and fro movements. The place will not change. But locomotion, the place also changes. So all these are some of the important characteristics which differentiates the living organisms from the non-living organisms. Okay, fine. So now what are we going to see is, there are some other parameters also, but these are the ones based on which the classification has been done. Okay, so that is why I have listed these important ones. Okay, so now what are we going to see is, I'll change the color. Okay, so we're going to see biodiversity. What is biodiversity? Biodiversity means bio is biological organisms, diversity is the differences. Okay, see, we are living in this particular, safe in this room. Okay, you have, see, humans are there, mammals are there, microbes are there. Okay, spiders are there. So you have a lot of biodiversified organisms. Okay, so that is called biodiversity. In the given area, a lot of organisms exist of different categories, not of same categories. That is called as biodiversity. Okay, now biodiversity plays a very important role in the nomenclature. So you know what is nomenclature, right? So nomenclature is the process of naming the organisms. Okay, so biodiversity of the living world, it is vast. Okay, so on what basis you think they would have classified? Okay, so is all that we're going to see now. First of all, taxonomy. You have to know these terms. Taxonomy, nomenclature. See, the one, I think you can differentiate the colors. Taxonomy is study of the process of naming. Okay. So nomenclature is the process of, nomenclature is a name. Okay. So you have certain rules and regulations based on which the naming is being done. Okay. The father of this taxonomy is none other than your Carolus Linnaeus. Carolus Linnaeus is a scientist who wrote a book on diversity of the organisms. So, and that is why he's called as father of taxonomy. Okay. Now, fine. So, on what basis they are naming is what we're going to see now. First and foremost thing is that they will identify where are they classified. Okay. So, they'll first see, if you see this green, then it means characteristic. Okay. So first thing is that their characteristics. What are the basic characteristics of that organism? So that thing they will analyze. Okay. So characteristics in the sense, see, for example, we are humans. Okay. So what kind of characteristics they'll analyze is that. How are they behaving? For example, we walk. Okay. We have hands and legs. So that is one. But microbes, they're microscopic. So they'll just take some broad characteristic, and then they will use that for classification. Next one is that classification. So based upon the characteristics, they will classify the organisms. Okay. So first they'll check the characteristics, then they'll classify, then they will name it. That is nomenclature. They will name them. So check the characteristics, put, classify them properly, and then name them. Okay, so how will you name them is that based upon their phylogeny. What is phylogeny is that? Phylogeny is a study of evolutionary characteristics, evolutionary history. So before naming, I will check their evolutionary history. See, just because by seeing the characteristics I can name, but that will not help. I have to check the evolutionary history. That may seem to be very, 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 you know, subtle organism, but that might have a very wild evolutionary history. You don't know. So if you put that under subtle organisms or domestic organisms, suddenly when it's the genes are like resuming back, it will become wild. So you have to for sure check the evolutionary history, which is nothing but the phylogeny. And then ontogeny. What is ontogeny is that? This is evolutionary history. This is life history. What is life history is? How are they born? From egg, how is the life cycle going on? Do they undergo metamorphosis? Are they oviparous? Are they viviparous? Or do they give rise to direct eggs? So how, right from the birth till the death, how is their life cycle is your ontogeny. But how is their ancestral characters, what is there in the gene is your phylogeny. So based on all this only, I will start naming the organism. So first I'll find out the unique characters, then I'll classify, I'll name them, I'll check the phylogeny and ontogeny. So these are the parameters based on which I'll start the naming. Okay. So after this, I will do the nomenclature, that is your naming, proper naming. For that, I have to do all these work, okay?